with their defense, what did you see about how they were able to limit Derrick Henry last week?
Yeah, you know, they loaded up the box. They want to be a single high team for the most part if they can. You know, they'll mix in a little bit of quarters and two deep, but, you know, they're predominantly a single high team that wants to get extra guys in the box and, you know, they want to make you one-dimensional, stop your run and make you throw it.
Jones didn't look like a player that was coming off that Achilles injury. Was it something that Tennessee wasn't doing to adjust to him, or was it more just like how productive he was?
No, he's just a really good player. He's always been a good player. You know, he's been a great pass rusher, and so it'll be a good test for us.
What did you see from their quarterback on Sunday?
You know, very dynamic, big-time arm, scrambles. You know, they do all kinds of different things with him, a lot of different things. Made a couple good blitz checks.
Mike, there was one play where he had a first down. He runs all the way to the right sideline, stops, runs all the way to the left sideline, stops, and then steps back and throws the ball for the first down. I mean, how do you defend that?
Well, you gotta be pretty disciplined and, you know, in the rush lanes. But, you know, saying that we're going to keep him in the pocket all day is not realistic. I mean, we got to do a great job, and if he gets out of the pocket, we've got to do a great job of locking on our receivers. You know, I can say we're going to keep him in the pocket all day, but I don't think that's truly going to happen.
And then there was one pass where he went right and threw across the middle like you're not supposed to, but, I mean, you just got to be aware of everything.
Yeah, he does. You know, there's some unorthodox things that he does. You know, I mean, it looks like sometimes, you know, he might have a rollout to the left and he'll take off and go to the right. I mean, just, you know, it's just his, the feel that he has for the game. So, yeah, we got to defend 53 yards.
Are there any other quarterbacks you've ever prepared for that Murray reminds you of?
It's hard to say. I mean, I'm sure there's some, you know, but you know, he's unique.
He's kind of a gunslinger, though. Do you look at him as someone, if you put him in a bad position, could turn the ball over and give you guys?
There's a possibility. I mean, you know, we have to hope that we can get some turnovers, yeah.
Mike, with them loading up the box and playing more single high safety, does that create more opportunities potentially to get the play action stuff going and take some shots downfield that way?
Potentially, yeah. If we can get some, you know, protection and get guys on the right guys and, you know, get some open looks.
Yeah, how are you feeling about the offensive line just going into this matchup across the board?
Well, I think honestly, you know, as you look back on that game, you know, we can truthfully say we didn't play very good on offense, okay? We still scored 24 points. So, you know, if we eliminate some of these penalties that we had and we do a little bit better job in some of the protections that we had, then I think we got a chance to be pretty good. you know, we're gonna have to make sure that we identify the fronts, identify the players. You know, they move Simmons around quite a bit, Buda Baker's around quite a bit. So we're going to have to identify the fronts, and quite honestly, it wouldn't surprise me to get the exact same front we saw last week.
We talked about Breland on Monday, but opposite him, what did you see from Patrick Peterson on Sunday?
I think Pat played pretty well. He didn't get much action. You know, one play they caught behind him, we were in zone, but he did fine.
Are there parallels you can draw just from like how Cincinnati would go three wide to all the weapons that Arizona has of like what that challenge is going to be for the secondary?
I don't understand your question.
Just how, I mean, the way that Cincinnati used, you know, Boyd, the three receivers, and just how many weapons, how they can spread it out in Arizona.
Yeah,
a lot of parallels between.
Yeah, they'll do the same thing. I mean, they'll have them three wides a lot, sometimes four wides. So, yeah, it's. I mean, that's who they are.
Mike, in terms of identifying the front, is that Garrett, Kirk, the whole line, everyone?
Well, a lot of it's Garrett, but a lot of it, you know, Kirk has some dealings with that too. And then part of it is the communication. You know, there's a couple times we didn't communicate it well. We end up blocking the wrong guy. And, you know, so, yes, part of it's communication, part of it's identifying the front. But it's as a group.
Cameron Dantzler was inactive last week. Just where is he at in his career, in your opinion? Where does, what does he need to do to get back on the field on Sunday?
First thing, he's got to play special teams. If you're a backup player, you play special teams.
Given their pass rush, Mike, would you like to see Kirk try to get the ball out a little bit quicker, perhaps on Sunday?
Excuse me?
Would you like to see Kirk get the ball out a little bit faster, given their pass rush, how quick they can get to the quarterback?
Yeah, it's all dictated on the plays. You know, you got, like I think I said the other day, you know, if you got max protection, then you can hold a little bit longer. If you got, if you're scatting the back, you know, you probably got to get it out a little bit quicker. So it's all based on, you know, what you're getting, what you're seeing, a lot of different things. You know, I think he only held the ball, and I know the reporter at halftime said, you know, I said this and that, but I think he just held it the one time. You know, they had a three-man rush when we were down on the 2-yard line. I thought he held it too long there. But other than that, I didn't see that he was just holding the ball.
Do you expect Anthony Barr to get some practice today?
I don't know. We'll see how he is. I talked to him a little bit today. He's feeling better than he did yesterday, so we'll just have to see where he's at.
But the things you can do to emphasize not taking penalties in a practice situation, or is that just purely left execution?
Yeah, I can run them. If they jump off sides, I can run. So I've done that before. It wouldn't surprise me to do it again, because if we start doing them, we get mad. But you know, the last person on the team, I guess, to flinch would be C.J. Ham on the first play of the game, you know, so. Good?
Thanks, everyone.